Hey everyone, today's Switch Day. Launch in Japan, I think launch worldwide actually. So, was able to get a Nintendo Switch at Costco, third place we tried. Sold out everywhere else. We got really lucky, one of the last ones available. So let's do an unboxing. This is a Japanese Switch. I don't know if the contents are going to be any different, probably exact same as the North American one. So, let's see what's inside. So, first the box. It's very sturdy, very nice looking one. Bright and colorful. This is gonna be hard to do one-handed. There we go. And first thing when you open it is the console itself on the right. And then we got our two Joy-Cons, where I got the neon one. So let's take these out, look at them one at a time. Okay, that is small. It feels like a kind of like an iPhone 6, but it's a little bigger. Honestly, it feels a bit like holding a Nook. It's heavy. It's got some weight to it. And then we've got our Joy-Cons here. The right Joy-Con and left. I'm gonna open these up and see how they feel, because everyone's talked about them being comfortable or uncomfortable. And I'm curious. One moment as I set this camera down. All right, I got a left Joy-Con here. And let the camera focus on that a little bit. The buttons feel, they're a little clicky, which is good. It's like the clickier than Wii U, about the same as the 3DS. We got these SL and SLR buttons. And to hold it in your hand, it's a little small, I will say that. For a really long gaming session, it might not be the most comfortable, but if you hold it loosely, it's not too bad. The joystick itself is good. And when held like a Wiimote, that is actually quite comfortable. So, holding it like this ain't bad. Holding it like this is a little uncomfortable. And then we've got the right one with the joystick just nestled right in the center there. That is a very bright neon. Okay. The joystick is nice. The buttons are all good here. Again, yeah, it's not ideal, but like, I don't know. It'll do for Mario Kart in a pinch when you want to play out on the go. I wouldn't want to play Smash on. No, I'd play Quick Game of Smash on this. But I wouldn't want to play something like Bayonetta, which I don't think you could even do. But Mario Kart, it'll be fine. If you had really big hands, this would be a pain in the ass, though. And let's open the dock itself, or the console itself. Okay, so we got some instructions on the side, I just noticed. So it seems like one, plug it in, two, snap on the Joy-Cons, and then start it up, I guess. So, here is the actual console. This thing is so small for like to run Breath of the Wild. That's gonna be really impressive. See the back. That is nice, clean looking back. And the kickstand. My first impression opening this is everything's a lot smaller than I expected. So we got our kickstand. Oh, that's where the micro SD goes, is under the kickstand. I didn't realize that. So, on a bed, it is not the most well rested. Let me check on a floor. Yeah, that holds up totally fine on a floor. But on a soft surface, be warned, it doesn't hold up on its own. All right. So, we've got our console itself here. Let's see what else is underneath. We've got HDMI, the AC adapter with USB-C, which will plug into the bottom there. Then this. Okay, yes, this is the grip for the Joy-Con. Let me snap the Joy-Con in here and see how does that work. Is there a button I gotta press? Okay, there we go. It's just a little plastic rail. There we go. We got our nice boxy square controller. That is pretty. I like the colors. Okay. And holding this, it's quite comfortable to have a left joystick and the buttons. That is very, very comfortable. Like that. But shooting game would be a little rough on this. I guess Splatoon you're gonna be aiming like that anyway. Oh yeah, there's that IR camera. I forgot about that. Well, so I think the Pro Controller will be a good addition, because this will be great for Breath of the Wild, but anything with a lot of right stick might be a little less comfortable. What else have we got here? This is the strap for the Joy-Con. One. And two. And over here is the dock, I believe. I can smell that plastic. Nintendo Switch dock. So, pretty simple. All plastic. Oh, I just got a text. And on the back side, we have the plugs for HDMI and AC adapter, which is also just USB-C. That's awesome because my phone uses USB-C. Okay, so to slide this in, okay, so I've got the Switch here and an unplugged dock. How do I... Oh, you just, like... That's it. Okay. I thought it'd go lower. It's, it just sits in there. It doesn't... It's not going to fall out or anything, so... Huh. Interesting. I thought it slid all the way in. I didn't realize the top pokes out like that. Okay, and I think that's pretty much everything in the box. The last thing I want to try... Actually, I want to try the Joy-Cons in every way possible. So let me try. How do I slide this off? Oh, okay. There's little buttons on the back there. You gotta press the button, and then you can slide the Joy-Con off. Slide the Joy-Con off. That's easy. Let's slide it onto the Switch. Ah, that is smooth. That's really easy to... Okay. It's very wide, which I'm kind of surprised about, but does not feel bad. The odd thing about this is that it's going to be hard to reach all the buttons at once. You're going to have to shift your hands as you play if you need to reach in a button that's not normally used. So, again, Zelda, I think it'll be fine, because I'm guessing it's going to be these four plus one or two of the triggers. But I wouldn't rest both fingers on the trigger. I think going back and forth is best. And then slide that off. And the last thing I wanted to try was Joy-Con with a grip. So I think it doesn't... Oh, it does matter. This is plus to plus. And where's the other grip? Here we go. And this one is minus two minus. So. Oh my god, that is so much better. This is so much better for, like, any game. I could see myself playing a game for a longer time on this without the grip. So that grip is going to be necessary for any kind of two or more player adventures. Again, yeah, this is, I'm actually trying to figure out which one I like better. They are different. They're definitely different when you look at where you put your thumb for the joystick. It'll take a little getting used to. I'm not going to write it off yet, because I know a lot of people tried it and hated it in the first second, but I think that once you realize how to hold your hand, you'll get comfortable with it. All right, so that's it for the Switch unboxing.
Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll probably upload some Breath of the Wild soon. So, later.